How's it going?
Good. How are you?
Good. What can I help you with?
Well, I have the prop pistol used by the villain in the 1995 James Bond movie, GoldenEye.
Very cool. There's no such thing as a bad James Bond movie. Just some are better than others.
I have the prop pistol used by the villain in the James Bond GoldenEye movie from 1995. According to my research, $3,000 seems to be about the average market street value for it. So that's what I'm hoping to get for it.
Every guy wanted to be James Bond. I mean, he was just so damn iconic. Everything about the series is amazing. Ian Fleming wrote, I think, like a dozen James Bond books. He sold over 100 million copies of them. The movies were insanely successful, and they'll probably be making James Bond movies 50 years from now. All right, it's a prop gun. It's made out of plastic or resin or something like that. Pretty cool. One of the villains was pointing this at James Bond.
Yes. It's been used in several key scenes in the film.
So where did you get it?
I got it online from a prop house in the UK.
Is this the paperwork right here?
This is the paperwork. That's the COA that came with it.
This letter certifies that the above item was production used in the film GoldenEye and various sequences in the film. Okay. How much do you want for it?
Well, you know, it's a tough call. I mean, there's so much sentimental value to it, which to me is priceless.
I don't care about sentimental value at all. I can't make money on it.
I'm thinking $3,000.
Okay. Let me call somebody who will know everything about this. I got a buddy who all he does is like Hollywood memorabilia. So let me have him take a look at it, see if he can screen match it.
Sounds good.
All right, give me 5 minutes. I'm gonna give him a call.
You got it.
Harrison, Rick Harrison.
How are you? Good to see you again.
What do we have today?
We have a gun prop from GoldenEye, James Bond.
Excellent, fantastic movies. Props have set record prices from those films. Very early films are the more desirable props, like Dr. No, which I think was the first film, From Russia with Love, Man with the Golden Gun.
Octopussy.
Octopussy. So anything we find from a James Bond film usually bring pretty good money at auction.
Okay.
Tell me where you purchased it.
Well, I purchased it online from a prop house, basically, in the UK.
And you have any idea where they acquired it from?
I believe initially they acquired it from Baptiste.
Okay,
film
yes.
Memory.
Baptiste probably made all of the weaponry you have ever seen in a James Bond movie.
Okay, so do you know which scene it was supposed to be in?
The opening scene, the chemical weapons plant, if you're familiar with the film.
Mm-hmm. Hard to tell if it was actually used in the film. For my authentication purposes, I happen to have a screenshot that I brought with me. In the photograph, it looks like it's not a static trigger. It looks like he actually is putting some pressure on the trigger. If I apply pressure to this trigger, it breaks. So you can also see in the photograph, there's a significant gun sight at the front of the gun. There is none here. There is a nib, but no gun sight. It raises questions. So with everything I can see, there's just too much inconsistency here for me to say it's that gun. But it certainly could be a gun from the film.
Okay.
But one of dozens that were made for the film.
Okay. Okay. Fair enough.
Okay. All right.
Okay. All right. Thanks,
Thank
man.
You, Rick. Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you, Rick.
Thank you.
I hate it when this happens, but I mean, like, if it was never used, it's not worth a lot, plain and simple. But if you can prove it's the real deal, I'll give you $3,000. You're the one who's going to have to go frame by frame to a 2-hour movie and try and find a screenshot that matches. And when you do it, make sure you download it in high def.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks, man.